Okay, so in this video, we're gonna look at moving, rotating, scaling, and cropping your video. Now, moving, rotating, and scaling as a whole is just kind of put into the group of transforming. So when we say about transforming a video, this is what we mean. Now, to do this in Filmora X, we just need to find our video that we want. We would usually, when changing this, do it before editing, which saves us the hassle of copy and pasting our effects. But in this scenario, we've already done our basic cut, so we're just going to have to copy and paste our effects when done. Now, to get into transforming, we just need to double click on the video clip, and this brings up our effects menu. Now, for this, I wouldn't say much transformation needs to be done, but if we want to rotate it, we can either use this scale up here, or we can move this text to the side and just get it where we want it. We're just gonna leave ours at zero. You can also flip this vertically, or you can flip this horizontally. These usually aren't done for this kind of video. You can then scale this to zoom in or zoom out. And then once scaled, if we want this to sit in the top corner, we can either drag and move this, or we can move the X and Y individually. So we're just gonna drag it and it'll snap. But because we haven't got anything behind it, again, we don't want ours moved. But a quick thing to add about this is that you don't have to use the controls on this side. You can use the on-screen controls. So you can drag by the corners to scale it and keep the right aspect ratio. Or we could decide that this looked better stretched. So we can stretch it from either the sides or the top. But this will distort the video, so I'd recommend not doing this. And then you can also rotate it on this control on the top here as well. You can also type into these side controls. So I'm just gonna type 100% and I'm gonna put these back to zero. This is now back to exactly how it was before. So to crop this, we can either scale it to be too large to fit in the frame, and then whatever is in frame, it will be cropped to, or we can click OK, go into effects, and then click on included, utility, and crop. I have this favorited because this is probably the most used effects. So for that, you can just go up into your favorite section. To apply this to a video, you just need to drag and drop it onto the clip that you want. And then you can see under here that there has been an effect added. To get to this effect, you just want to double click on the video and scroll down to the video effects at the bottom. Once we're in the video effects, we can crop the left side, the right side, the top, and the bottom to get what we want it to look like. I don't think this video needs to be cropped, but if we wanted to, this is a way we could do it. You can also turn on zoom, which will basically just distort your image and stretch it. So again, we're not gonna have this on. You can then also feather your edge. This basically just means that it's not a solid edge, but it just kind of fades a little bit. So we're gonna turn that off, and then we're gonna turn that back to zero. If we want to remove this effect, we can click the X, and if we just wanna hide it, then we can click the tick here. So if we wanted to crop this so it looked like we've added what is called a letterbox, then we could move this up to 15. This is not necessarily a specific size, it's just kind of a number that's noticeable and that is easy to remember. If we want to turn this effect off, we can click the tick and it will do that. And if we want to remove it completely, we can click this X here. And then we can click OK. Now, you may not use the things in this video all the time, but it is some of the fundamentals that you need to know. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, please leave a like on this video and consider subscribing. Also check out the rest of the videos in this playlist, where next we'll be looking at adding music.